I was 16, and there were many smaller children in that transport. We went by train.
Well, explain a little bit more about the transport and how you came to even be on it.
Well, that I don't know much about because my parents arranged it. But it was the Joint Distribution Committee had arranged with the government to allow Jewish children to leave, and had arranged with the English government to allow them in, subject to them being looked after morally and financially by somebody till they were 18 years of age. And I don't know what was involved. I just found myself on this train and my parents on the platform and the train moving out, and that was horrible. And to this day, when I take my son to the airport, he lives in London, when I take my son to the airport, I always think of it and think, will I ever see him again? You know, that will never leave me, that thought, the two of them. It was such, being a mother now, I can realize what a sacrifice it was for them to send me away.
Describe how your parents told you that you were going to go on this transport.
You know, I can't remember. It was just arranged, you're going, and, you know, and only going for 2 or 3 months, and we'll be picking you up, and it isn't a big thing. And I was used to traveling. That part didn't faze me. And yet the minute that that train was pulling out, I wanted to get off that train again. I didn't really want to go.
What was the image that you have of your parents on that day?
Just the two of them on that platform, just standing there and holding on to each other, you know. And as I said, having a child of my own, I realized what a moment and what a sacrifice that was, because they really didn't know whether they were ever going to see me again. And yet I understand from people who came back from Theresienstadt, who knew my father there and my mother, and they said they just had a picture, and they said they were never more grateful in their lives that I'm not with them.